It was an interesting drive getting up here right now. We are on the shoulder in a safe place here off State Highway 150, not maybe a couple of miles away from the 101. Behind me, you see the flames over there off in the distance here in this in ranch area. Evacuation orders around here have been in effect, and this is how the fire has been moving through Carpinteria right now. The winds are very, very light, and it's basically just shooing it from left to right on your screen right now. But let me show you what it was like earlier this morning. Take a look. This was the northbound side of the 101 freeway. When we were heading north from the 126, it was reopened. And then a few miles north of Highway 33, it came to a stop because of the flames on both sides of the freeway. At one point, the CHP escorted traffic heading south on the 101 freeway, and we were at a complete standstill. And then, slowly, we were escorted north, and then we finally made it into Carpinteria and got off the 101 here, and we found this spot. The fire is... it's basically just going where it wants with the help of some wind right now. The wind has died down a little bit here, but as you can see, from left to right, it's going up the hill, up to the top here, and as it's heading towards the city of Carpinteria right now. Folks in Carpinteria have been told basically to get ready and go just in case it gets over here, but there is a lot of dry fuel, as Sean, if you want to pan to the right. It is just thick, it is dry, and as you can see, it hasn't burned in a while. And what you see coming and floating down here are embers and ash, and that's scary as well. To the right, it's an equestrian center that's been vacated. I see another large house on the end over here, so there aren't a lot of properties here, but you've got, below it, you've got a vineyard, you've got a lot of brush that can be burned. But again, the wind here for now, where we are, is light.